In this last video on DNA, we're going to look a bit closer at what happens when there are mistakes when the DNA is copied. Mutations are changes in the DNA sequence. If there is a change in the DNA sequence, as we learned from transcription, this can result in a change in the mRNA sequence. There are several types of mutations which are caused simply by affecting one nucleotide or one base pair of the DNA. A substitution mutation is when one letter is changed for another. An insertion mutation is when one extra letter is added to the DNA sequence. And a deletion mutation is when one or a few letters are removed from the DNA sequence. What we're going to see is that these different types of mutations can have different impacts on the protein as a result. A substitution mutation results when one letter is changed for another. At most, this substitution mutation changes one amino acid within the protein. It does not change the reading frame, or it does not change the grouping in which we use to identify the codons. Substitution mutations are less likely to have a negative detrimental impact, like we would see with an insertion or a deletion mutation. Now, with that said, there are still some genetic disorders which are caused by substitution mutations. Insertion or deletion mutations add or remove a letter from the DNA sequence. This can cause what's known as a frameshift. Mutation. Frameshift mutations end up shifting the reading frame, and this can cause an impact everywhere from the point of mutation down on through the rest of the protein. Frameshift mutations often will impact multiple amino acids, not just a single one. So what is a frameshift? Well, a frameshift is a change in the codon reading frame. Recall that each codon is exactly 3 bases long. And the next codon starts as soon as the first ends. If what used to be a 3-letter codon has a deletion in it and it has only 2 letters, it will then take the first letter of the next codon, and the next codon will now be shifted as well and will be a new combination of letters coding for a very different amino acid. Changes in the reading frame result in frameshift mutations. Which scramble all the codons after that point of mutation. Frameshifts occur whenever one or two bases are added or lost from a coding section of a gene. Here we'll look at a few examples of how these types of mutations would end up impacting the message of that mRNA. If we use the English language as an example, but we set the same codon rules where each word is exactly 3 letters long, and as soon as the first word ends, the next 3 letters make up the next word, we have our starting sentence. The fat cat ate the rat. So in this case, the sentence has meaning. It follows the rules where all of the words are 3-letter words. Now, a substitution mutation would be if one letter was changed for another. Let's imagine that C in cat is instead changed to B. Now we have the fat bat ate the rat. There's a slight change, but the sentence is still there. Most of the meaning is still there. We just have a slightly different subject now. On contrast, if instead we said there was a deletion of that C, while still keeping the rules that each word has to have exactly 3 letters and pick up as soon as the last word ends off, we find with the deletion of the C that our sentence becomes the fat, A-T-A, T-E-T, H-E-R, A-T. None of those words were in the original sentence, and most of them aren't even words at all. We see a drastic change to that sentence after the deletion. Now what if instead we had an insertion or a duplication? What if we had two C's instead of just one in cat? Well, now suddenly the sentence reads, the fat CCA, TAT, ETH, ERA. Again, none of those words were in the original sentence, and the total meaning of the sentence has been lost. This is why frameshift mutations are so much more detrimental than the typical substitution mutation will be. In frameshift mutations, they usually destroy the function of the protein, because there isn't just a change in one amino acid, it changes many amino acids. In fact, one of the things that typically happen with a frameshift mutation is that you end up getting a stop codon much earlier in the gene than otherwise expected. It truncates the gene, and this definitely changes the shape of the resulting protein. In contrast, a substitution mutation will result in a single change. Sometimes these will be what are known as silent mutations, where there will be a change in the DNA, a change in the RNA, but that changed codon still codes for the same amino acid. Remember, we saw there was a redundancy in the genetic code, so sometimes mutations in the DNA won't end up changing the protein at all. Or if it does change the protein, typically it will be a single amino acid change. And depending on where in the protein that changes, it might not end up impacting the function of that protein at all. So to bring this discussion of the central dogma to a close, remember that genes are inherited as DNA. DNA is transcribed into mRNA during transcription. RNA is translated into protein during translation. This flow of information is known as the central dogma. Of genetics. Proteins give organisms their traits, and so mutations in DNA end up producing changes in the traits of the organism. This is our last video on genetics. In our next videos, we'll start talking about anatomy and physiology of humans. See you in the next video.